Women to Women on BCTV is supported by Women to Women.
Women's Show. I'm Alison Snyder, and I welcome you today. Women to Women is managed by the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance and encourages women to create connections, gain knowledge, open doors, and build strategic alliances, and much, much more. Our goal is to create more women leaders in Berks County by providing a forum where women from diverse backgrounds can learn, share ideas, and mentor each other. So today we're going to talk about the amazing year of programming that we had through the Women to Women, and we're going to also take a look at what's ahead in the future. There's a lot of excitement going on with our Women to Women programs. So today I have with me, I'm happy to have with me as my guest today, Karen Marsdale, who is the Senior Vice President of Special Programs, and Rachel Romig, who's a Special Programs Coordinator, both on the staff of the Grading Reading Chamber. So welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining me today.
It's a pleasure.
So we've got so much to talk about, but I know, Rachel, the last time we met, we took a little bit of time to talk to the audience about the expo.
Yeah.
So now it's here and gone, and what can you tell us? How did it all work out?
So the conference and expo was amazing. It was our 8th annual, so again, it was great. Overall, for the whole day, we had 415 for our breakfast, where we have our Athena Award. And then for the entire conference day, we had 340 women join us.
That's a lot.
Yeah. So the number keeps rising. We're maxing out our venues, and we love it. But we had just a wonderful day. So, so since I mentioned that we started our day with the Athena breakfast, I wanted to talk quickly about that. Because everyone watching today has the distinct pleasure of meeting our 2019 Athena recipient. And that
cheers,
is Alison
cheers,
Snyder.
Cheers to Alison.
So if you don't know what the Athena Award is, we offer that every year to a woman or man in the community who is just a beacon of light for our community, who is giving back to the community, advocating for women in the workplace, and just being there for all ages of men and women in the community to better our community. So I want to tell you a little bit about Alison, because as our host, she's the one that's always asking the questions and we're the ones talking. But we want to tell you about Alison right now because we're so proud of her and just so happy that she's part of our organization. So she is the Assistant Vice President of Personnel at East Penn Manufacturing. And she's served in various HR functions since 1987. And she's served on many boards, including the Berks County United Way, the Q Board, which is an organization for positive employee relations, and was president of the American Society for Training and Development, the Berks County chapter. Currently, she serves on the Penn State Berks Advisory Council, the GRCA Women to Women Council, and has volunteered for the Red Cross and Friend Inc. for the past 7 years. She serves on the Girl Scouts of Eastern Pennsylvania Board and has worked on the Girl Scouts Take the Lead Dinner committee and served as their chairperson for 2 years. Her awards and accolades are just as vibrant. And I'm going to keep on going because I know no one likes to talk about themselves, but everyone needs to know how amazing she is. She was inducted into the Berks County Aquatic Hall of Fame and in the Wilson School District Academic Hall of Fame. In 2016, she was honored by the Girl Scouts with the Take the Lead honor. And in 2018, she won the Executive Baker Challenge for Friend Inc. On top of all that, she's a certified Aqua Zumba instructor and has coached the Wilson School District in swimming for 31 years. So we are just so lucky to have a woman like Alison on our Women to Women Council. She's an advocate for women in the community, all ages, just bettering Berks. So we thank you for being here with us, like you always thank us for being here with you on the show. So thank you.
Well, thank you, Rachel. And I was truly honored, and you guys did such a great job at the event. And it was really nice to have so many of the people that I work with. And truly, I have to thank East Penn, too, for allowing me the opportunity to be able to do all of the things that I'm able to do, because East Penn definitely believes in helping out in the community and doing the best that you can. So I'm very grateful to have such a great employer, and I'm very grateful to you guys for the recognition. It's very, very nice. So thank you so much.
Well, Alison, I can tell you that, you know, obviously, Rachel and I were just thrilled doing sort of the happy dance when I announced this to Rachel. And I want to say that something that I thought was just marvelous was when I called some of your colleagues at East Penn, because we just couldn't, you know, contain ourselves. And after we talked to you, and you could just see the excitement and the pride that they had in you and how much they love you. And I think being in a senior level role in human resources is always a challenge, as we know. But to know that you got this support network of other colleagues, you truly deserved that.
Oh, well, thank you so much.
We were just thrilled.
Yeah.
All right, so enough about me. Let's move on.
But that was how we kicked off the day. It was the best way to kick off the day.
And so many people, didn't they say? It was just like it just started the day.
It was.
And we had there were very many excellent speakers this year. Mm-hmm.
There were. We had two keynote speakers this year. We had four breakout sessions. And we added this year what we called the Book Nook, where we sold professional development books that complemented all of our breakout sessions. So we had over 40 sponsor tables there, women-owned businesses. Mm-hmm. So the whole day was just a really well-rounded day, as it has been in the past. But it was a really great year this year.
If you're watching in the audience, if you've never had the chance to go to the expo, you really should take a look at it. We try to do it every April, and it's a great day just to give a little bit back to yourself, to renew yourself, renew your energy, meet other people, and really take advantage of it if you can. So thanks so much. Mm-hmm. All right. So I know you've been working towards getting more women of all ages involved in Women to Women programming, and especially for the conference and expo. Did you see any new faces this year?
We really did. We always survey all the attendees after the event to make sure that we're on track with what they're looking for. And this year, of the 100 that responded to our survey, about half had never been to the conference before. So that is just a really positive step for us, because we're obviously reaching new women in the community who have never experienced this before, and that's what we're always trying to do. This year, we also worked with Alvernia University, one of our sponsor partners, to offer free tickets for our breakout sessions to some of the college-age students. And I believe 10 of them took advantage of that.
Which is great.
We got to reach a younger demographic as well, to introduce them to some professional working women at their college age and to get to experience these professional development workshops. So we are really proud of that this year.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So, Karen, this past Women's Conference and Expo was the 8th annual. I haven't been to all 8, but I know you have been, because you're basically the mother of all of this. You know, you were part of your job at the Chamber has been working with this, but I know, you know, you have a special love for the Women to Women group and all the work that you've done there. And what would you say was the most exciting changes that you've seen over the 8 years of the Expo?
You know, I think what I've seen the Expo become and mature into is, early on, it was a little bit of a health expo, you know, health and wellness, and sort of taking a day for yourself it truly is a time for you to take a day away from the office, from whatever it is that you're involved in on a daily, weekly basis. But I'm seeing the expo really become, and this is why this year we called it the conference and expo. So there's an expo meaning all of the vendors, but the conference really has evolved into a real opportunity for women in the community to learn from and gain more professional knowledge for their own well-being, for their own professional guidance and development. And I think it's one reason why, and Rachel and I talk about this all the time, companies, institutions in our community are taking advantage of using our conference to help women and to give women the opportunity, I shouldn't say help, but give them that opportunity to further their professional careers. And I'm seeing that change, which is just great. And I think this is one reason why we're seeing more younger women. It's sort of filtering down in terms of the buzz is coming from around the community. And so I think that, to me, that is really the epitome of what we strive to be.
So I think, you know, it was great for me to see there were a lot of companies like East Penn. We had over 30 women there from our organization.
Mm-hmm. Which, here.
It was really excellent. And I think it's such a great opportunity for all kinds of women to be able to get some reassurance of what they're doing and to learn some new things. Like, even if you come away with one or two or three new things that can help you make yourself professionally better and meet some other people that maybe do similar jobs at other companies, what a great experience.
And I think that's, you know, as Rachel and I really have worked this year, and she's been a great resource and kind of saying to me as we've worked with the council, that there needs to be takeaways. You know, this is absolutely time away from your day-to-day job. Women need and want takeaways that they can use back at the office. They also want to feel more empowered. And this is, together, they can, this is what's happening, I think.
So it's kind of the path I see Women to Women going is getting it a little bit more relatable to the workplace.
Absolutely.
And giving people skills, and that's really excellent. So I know this year our programming is coming to a close with just a couple of things left to go, but Rachel, what can you tell us about what things to expect maybe towards the end of this year in the summer yet?
Yeah.
And then for next year?
So, like Alison said, we're finishing up the program year. Over the summer, though, we don't stop. So, something that we're really proud of that this is our third year is our Youth Summer Reading Program, where we work with donors in the community who give back to us so that we can purchase at least 1,000 books, and we distribute them to organizations in the community so that we can help curb the summer slide of learning for kids age 8 through 12. And this year, our book of choice was The One and Only Ivan. It's based on a true story about a gorilla that was in a mall for a very long time and then was taken to the Atlanta Zoo. But in the fictional story, Ivan, this silverback gorilla, meets a young elephant and realizes through an unexpected friendship that there's more to the world and that he could help this baby elephant have a good life. And it really has a lot of messages in here that your unexpected friendships can come from nowhere and they can really change your life in a positive way. So we were able to purchase 1,200 of these books this year and distribute them to the community. We've reached about 30 organizations for these summer book clubs. And on June 10th, we have a kickoff of the summer for our program. It's our movie night. And we have a private movie showing in the Fox Berkshire Theater. And this year, we're watching Victoria and Abdul, which stars Judi Dench, and she becomes friends with one of her servants, and they form this amazing bond that no one really saw coming, and it really changes her life, her perspective on life and how to treat others, which is really falls in line with the book. So we're spreading positivity, and we can't wait for our Youth Summer Reading Program to kick off. We also have our last De Mujer a Mujer, our Latina Initiative event. It's on June 20th, and it's our awards ceremony. So it's the first annual Latina Initiatives Awards ceremony, and we have three categories where we've accepted nominations to offer awards in. So Community Impact Award, Young Latina, and Small Business Owner Award. We're judging currently, and we're very excited to have this award ceremony and just elevate these Latina women who are doing so many amazing things in our community, just as our Athena winner does. So, and then a look to the new year. We have topics from creating an 18-month plan for your personal and professional life, career plateaus, how to figure out whether you should stay or go, what's your plan for the future, strategies to stand out and step up, and emotional intelligence, which is a big one. And we always survey our attendees for the events so that we're in line with what they want to hear. And these are just some of the categories that women wanted to hear in our community. Mm-hmm. And then we always have our monthly Mujer a Mujeres, which is our Latina initiative for our inspirational speaking from women in the community who to share their story. So we have a really the summer is not an off time for us, so we're planning for the whole new year, and we'll have everything by the fall.
So hopefully maybe at our next broadcast we can talk a little bit about what we have carved in stone, but it sounds like a lot of exciting programs coming up and a very robust schedule.
Yes,
for sure.
It will be.
Yeah, so with all these great things coming. There's big changes for Women to Women too. And while it was announced at the Conference and Expo annual dinner this year, many still might not know that Karen is going to be retiring from the Greater Reading Chamber this year, and only a couple weeks away, I believe, Karen, right?
Absolutely. And I am retiring at the end of next week.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. And we just can't thank Karen enough for all that she has done, you know, really taking Women to Women from a baby and developing it into the mature program that it is now. It's really, really blossomed thanks to all of your love and support and, you know, all the great work that you've done for the chamber and for all the people and women of Berks County. We just can't thank you enough, Karen. And I know you're still going to be involved. You're not going to totally walk away.
I certainly am not. I've actually, you know, started to look at some things that I'm going to be doing in the future. But, you know, I think that, as I like to say, I sort of birthed the baby. And now Rachel is going to be director of Women to Women, and so now she has the adolescent to deal with. And
the cranky teen.
The cranky teen. But you know what? I am so thrilled because a year and a half ago, Rachel joined our team, and I really saw something in her, and it was borne out in just the way she approached the position that she had, and we worked together as a team. We always just work together as a team. So I'm very excited around the great women like Alison and so many others that are going to be still part of our council. I just see bigger and better things coming for Women to Women because it's so needed. So many people have told me throughout other communities, I wish I had a Women to Women here. Wish we had this sort of this resource. And I was blessed to be able to work for an organization that sort of gave me carte blanche in doing this something as we, you know, just forged new territory. And now it's time for me to sort of look at other areas that I want to be involved in on my own time, if you will, in my own space, and for all of you to go forth and conquer, and I know you're going to do it.
And we couldn't have done it without you getting it started, Karen.
Thank you.
And we just can't thank you enough. Your energy and enthusiasm for this is just unmatched. And the great job you did mentoring Rachel also to become such an outstanding person.
And thank you. I mean, I have to say I was really given, it was teamwork all the time. And I came in and had ideas and she listened to them and it gave me the opportunity to run with some ideas and, you know, all of these things have been embraced by the women around our table, and we all only have the best intentions mm-hmm. for women in the community, and that's very clear. So I'm very, very excited to keep things moving. I have big shoes to fill, but I know she'll be at all the Women to Women events. She gets a free ticket every time. She'll be there forever.
Oh, my God. And Rachel brings a perspective that I think I was really... We needed this perspective, and Rachel brings it with so much passion and also with a great skill set. So, I mean, it's the whole enchilada. It's the whole package. And so I'm really going to look forward to sitting there and just seeing how all of you are, you know, still working toward building more women leaders. Yeah.
Well, I can say you two definitely walk the talk when it comes to empowering women and each other and supporting each other. And that's so important in the world. We don't
it
have
sure
enough
is.
Of that.
Yeah.
And it's great to see that. And I think that's part of why we have the basis of why our programs are so great.
Yeah.
So thank you so, so much.
Amen.
Yes. So what's anything exciting in the plan for the future of Women to Women that you can tell us about?
I know that we're really excited for the new program year. We're going to continue reaching younger college-age women. That is a big push for us in general. Especially in the GRCA, we are always talking about attracting and retaining talent and keeping people in Berks and bringing people to Berks because it's a great place to live and thrive, work, play. So building these skills in young women while they're in college here in Berks to expand their horizon and meet some professional women here, see what the opportunities are here, I would have loved that when I was in college. So that's a big push for us, and we're going to keep bringing things that women want to hear and pushing the envelope on what women in the workplace means and how we can advocate for one another and build each other up, and those are the exciting things.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Well, we'd like to say a big congratulations to Rachel for her promotion and carrying the Women to Women project moving forward into the future. We also want to say a big congratulations to Karen for her retirement and thank her all of her hard work over the years.
It's been my pleasure.
And, yeah, you've been wonderful, so we can't thank you enough. So just remember out there, if you are interested in becoming a member of Women to Women or maybe just trying out one of the events, all you need to do is go to the website, which is www.burkswomen2women.com and sign up. That's all you need to do. It lists all the programs and all the things that are happening there. You can also visit Women to Women on Facebook, see what it's all about, and Instagram. You can follow and like and get a little bit of a flavor for what Women to Women's all about. But we really encourage you, if you're somebody that is looking for some support in the workplace, you want to grow as a person, this is an absolutely excellent opportunity for you, and we encourage you to take advantage of it. So with that, we thank you, and we'll see you at our next program.
Women to Women on BCTV is supported by Women to Women.